بسم اللہ الرحمن الرحیم. السلام علیکم اسٹوڈنٹس، ویلکم ٹو دا کلاس آف آرگنائزیشنل بیہیویئر. آئی ایم یور انسٹرکٹر شمائلہ منصور. ٹوڈے وی ول اسٹارٹ وتھ چیپٹر 2. چیپٹر ٹائٹل از ڈائیورسٹی ان آرگنائزیشن. اکارڈنگ ٹو دا کورس آؤٹ لائن وی ول اسٹڈی اباؤٹ ڈیموگرافک اور بایوگرافیکل کیریکٹرسٹک، نمبر 2 ابیلٹی، اینڈ دین امپروونگ ڈائیورسٹی مینجمنٹ اسٹریٹجیز. Let me explain this topic to you. As we are and each of us is unique. Definitely this is obvious enough, but managers sometimes forget they need to recognize and capitalize on individual differences to get most from their employees. So in this chapter we will learn how individual characteristics like age, gender, race, ethnicity and abilities can influence employee performance. We will also see how managers can develop awareness about these characteristics and manage diverse workforce effectively. We will also have an overview perspective of the changing workforce of the times. After studying this chapter, you should be able to achieve the following objectives. Number 1 is describe the 2 major forms of workforce diversity. Then you should be able to demonstrate how workplace discrimination undermines organizational effectiveness. At the third point, you would be able to describe how the key biographical characteristics are relevant to organizational behavior. Then you will be able to explain how other differentiating characteristics factor or contribute into organizational behavior. Then you will be able to demonstrate the relevance of intellectual and physical abilities to organizational behavior. Last but not the least is describe how organizations manage diversity effectively. First of all, I will explain what is workforce diversity. Diversity refers to the ways in which people are similar or different from each other. It may be defined by any characteristic that varies within a particular work unit, such as gender, race, age, education, tenure, or functional background. Such as being engineer versus being an accountant. Differences between workforce due to the demographic characteristics or biographical characteristics are relatively visible and stable. Understanding how these characteristics shape organizational behavior is very important. Though diversity may occur with respect to many characteristics, but our focus will be on diversity with respect to demographics, especially gender, race, age, religion, physical abilities, and sexual orientation. Understanding how these characteristics shape organizational behavior is very important. While many organizations publicly rave about the benefits of diversity, they may find it challenging to manage diversity effectively. This is evidenced by the number of complaints filed by the Equal Employment Opportunity Commission regarding the discrimination. Because when the discrimination pop up within the organization, it may create many harmful effects on the effectiveness or the performance of the organization. Now we are discussing levels of workplace diversity, or you can say it the forms of workplace diversity. Everyone brings differences to the organizations where they work. These differences can create energy and excitement in the workplace, but they can also cause conflict. So it is important that we have an understanding of how diversity works in organizations. We must have an understanding that how diversity management is done within organization. When we look at the workplace, we recognize the 2 levels of diversity. Number 1 is surface level diversity, and number 2 is deeper level diversity. Levels of diversity helps to find out differential attributes of the workforce due to the different demographic characteristics. So number one is surface level diversity. Surface level diversity reflects differences in easily perceived characteristics such as we have discussed earlier, gender, race, ethnicity, age, disability, etc. So these do not necessarily reflect the ways people think or feel, but they may activate certain stereotypes. I will explain stereotypes later in the next slides. And then at the second level of diversity is the deep level diversity. Deep level diversity reflects differences in values, personality, and work preferences, etc. These become progressively more important for determining similarity as people get to know one another better. While we are supporting the idea of having diversity within an organization, we must not forget that it may arise certain conflicts, such as workplace discrimination. Discrimination means to note the differences between things, which is not a bad thing, but unfair discrimination assumes and promotes stereotypes about groups. So what are these stereotypes? I will define in the next slide. Managing diversity effectively requires working to eliminate unfair discrimination. However, when we allow our behavior to be influenced by stereotypes about groups of people, then it will promote negative environment in the organization. And refusal to recognize individual differences is harmful to organizations and for its employees. Recognizing people for their abilities rather than assumptions of stereotypes is an important part of the study of organizational behavior. Discrimination at the workplace may lead towards a stereotyping. So what is this stereotyping? Stereotyping refers to judging someone on the basis of one's perception of the group to which that person belongs. Generally, we form stereotypes regarding racial characteristics, regarding cultural characteristics. We form stereotyping of the group on the basis of their socio-cultural and socio-economic status. From the gender-based stereotypes are also there. So how these stereotypes are harmful? Stereotype threat. The degree to which we internally agree with the generally negative stereotype perception of our group. So conclusively, we can say that unfair discrimination results in making judgments about individuals based on stereotypes regarding their demographic groups. Under the topic of workplace discrimination, I will discuss here the forms of discrimination. So this exhibit has listed the types of discrimination, then definition of the discrimination, and examples from the organization. So first of all, there is discriminatory policies and practices. We can define it in a way that actions taken by the representatives of the organization that deny equal opportunity to perform or unequal reward for performance. For example, older workers may be targeted for layoff because they are highly paid and have lucrative benefits. Secondly, another form of discrimination is sexual harassment. We can define it. Sexual harassment could be defined as unwanted sexual advances and other verbal or physical conduct of a sexual nature that create a hostile or offensive work environment. Example could be salespeople at one company went on company paid visits to strip clubs, brought strippers into the office to celebrate promotions, and fostered pervasive sexual rumors. Then at third point, intimidation. Intimidation is also a form of discrimination. We can define it overt threat or bullying directed at the members of specific groups of employees. Examples could be African American employers at some companies have found nooses hanging over their workstations.
Then the fourth form of discrimination could be mockery or insult. We can define it as joke or negative stereotype. Sometimes the result of joke taken too far. Example could be the Arab Americans have been asked at work whether they were carrying bombs or were members of terrorist organizations. So another form of discrimination is exclusion. We can define exclusion as exclusion of certain people from job opportunities, social events, discussion or informal mentoring can occur unintentionally. For example, many women in finance claim that they are assigned to marginal job roles or are given light workloads that do not lead to promotion. Then another form of discrimination is incivility. Incivility could be defined as disrespectful treatment, including behaving in an aggressive manner, interrupting the person or ignoring his or her opinion. Example could be female lawyers note that the male attorneys frequently cut them off or do not adequately address their comments. But increasing legal scrutiny and social disapproval had reduced most overt forms of discrimination, but less obvious forms like incivility and exclusion and mockery and insult in the milder form continue to exist. This type of discrimination can be difficult to eliminate because it is less likely to easily observed because it is not always intentional. So even so, it can have serious negative implications for an organization, including reduced productivity, increased turnover, and increased conflict among employees.
This was today's lecture. I hope you understand it. Please find the resource material from the folder and please revise it. Inshallah, in the next lecture, we will discuss biographical characteristics in detail. Allah Hafiz.